ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، أرسله الله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. أما بعد، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز المحكم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، ما كان إبراهيم يهوديا ولا نصرانيا ولكن كان حنيفا مسلما وما كان من المشركين. ويقول الله تعالى أيضا في كتابه العزيز المحكم، وما جعل عليكم في الدين من حرج، ملة أبيكم إبراهيم هو سماكم المسلمين من قبل، وفي هذا ليكون الرسول عليكم شهيدا، وفي هذا ليكون الرسول شهيدا عليكم وتكونوا شهداء على الناس، فأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة، فأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة، واعتصموا لله واخلصوا دينكم لله. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, in this Friday sermon, there is one question which has been repeatedly coming to us. So I want to answer that question in this Friday sermon. But before I even begin, let me ask, I will ask you and I will answer. So let me ask, we as the congregation of this masjid, which sect of Islam do we belong to? Are we from this madhab or this madhab, or this cult or this cult, or this sect or this sect, or such and such? Which sect specifically do we belong to? That question has been frequently asked, and many people approached me and asked me that question. So today is the time I'm trying to answer, to give the answer on that question. This answer, I'm not getting it from my mind, from quoting somebody, but I'm just quoting it from the Quran. My reference is all about the Quran now. So that question, it's Allah the Almighty who is giving us the answer. People keep asking us, are you the congregation of this masjid, are you guys Shia? When you say no, then they'll say, oh, well, are you Sunni? And if you say yes, then they will ask you, well, are you Malikiya or Shafi'iya or Hanbaliya or Ahmadiyya or Hanafiya or whatever? Then if you say yes, then there will be another question leading to that. So each question leads you to another question. Whenever you provide answer, then you should also be ready for the next answer. Then they will keep asking you, are you guys then Salafiya or Sufiya? Or then, or, well, if you pick up any one of them, then other questions, subsidiary questions are there also for you to answer. Then, okay, say you are even Sufiya, Ahlul Sunnah, or Tama'a, or whatever you pick up, then they will keep asking you, well, are you then if you are in that category, well, are you the Sufi of Qadiriyya, the Sufi of Tijaniyya, the Sufi of so and so, Salihiyya, and so and so. So that question never ends. And your answer must be ready all the time. You should keep answering that those questions. Well, so if what the question is about your identity. So you keep identifying yourself, and while you are claiming that you are Muslim, and you self-identify. And those questions and their answers are always one after another. It's just like you are peeling an onion. If you pick up one onion and you start peeling up, then you will remove one layer, and then you keep removing the next layer, until it's over. The same thing applies to our identification as Muslims. If we go far from Muslim, then we will keep building it and building it until we stand zero. We come to zero. Therefore, my answer to this question is that. It's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about that. Allah sent to us a Kitab, a Quran, with our messenger Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And he gave us name. He didn't leave us without identity. He said anyone who completes this condition is a Muslim. He gave us the name of our religion as Islam. And he gave us our name as Muslims. The two names, one is the noun and the other one is the person who is doing that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الدين عند الله الإسلام إن الدين عند الله الإسلام. Indeed, religion in the sight of Allah, the Almighty, is only Islam. Religion is nothing else. No other religion is accepted. It's only Islam. And when you say that as Islam, then it is that you said Islam is your religion, and you accepted that. When you accepted that Islam is your religion, then you must perform that as Islam. You have to continue it as Islam and make sure it is what you have said. And so then, when Allah is saying inna deena indallahi al-islam, indeed religion is only Islam, it doesn't mean that it is only this, the last message sent with Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Mm-hmm. It's all the religions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have sent, they were all Islam, because they were guiding the one who accepted it, they were guiding it to the monotheism of Allah, that Allah alone is the one who deserves to be worshipped. Therefore, what is Islam is not limited to our Quran and the message sent with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's also the religion. It's all Ibrahimi religions. The religion is sent with Ibrahim, be it now you call it Judaism or you call it Christian, it's all Islam. And what proof is that? Is that they call for monotheism, one Allah, one God. Why it is that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ما كان إبراهيم يهوديا ولا نصرانيا ولكن كان حنيفا مسلما وما كان من المشركين. Indeed, Prophet Ibrahim was neither Jew or Judaism, not Christian, but he was only a Muslim and he was not one of the polytheists, Mushrikeen. So Prophet Ibrahim was Muslim. That makes the Judaism to be Islam. And anyone who fulfills it exactly the way it is a Muslim. And Christianity is Islam. So all those religions inherited from Prophet Muhammad, Prophet Ibrahim, peace be upon him, are Islamic religion. But with the, different messengers. And all of them were carrying one message, which is the oneness of Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one only, and nothing can be associated with it, with worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's how it was. And all of them, liyuqimu salata, to establish the prayer, to pay charity, all of them have the same commandments. And so different messengers in different eras makes the a little bit difference, but all of them are Islam. Therefore, our religion is Islam, and we are Muslim. And what makes that? Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that repeatedly, and it is repeatedly mentioned in the Quran when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to say, "Qul innani hadani Rabbi." إلى صراط مستقيم دينا قيما ملة إبراهيم حنيفا وما كان من المشركين. Indeed, my Lord guided me to the straight path. To the straight path. And that straight path is دينا قيما. Is a religion which is pure and straightforward. And what is that? It is ملة إبراهيم. Is the religion of Ibrahim, who was pure to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Allah alone, and he was not one of the mushrikeens. He never became. So that is a very clear message. And alongside that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that he gave us the name which is exactly given to us by Prophet Ibrahim. Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا جَعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجٍ مِلَّةَ أَبِيكُمْ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. Allah did not make in religion hardship for you. It is easy, implementable, and very accessible. So that religion which is that is مِلَّةَ أَبِيكُمْ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. Is the religion of your father, your grandfather, Ibrahim. Huwa sammakumul muslimina. It is he who named you Muslims. He gave us Muslims min qablu, before. Wafi hada, and this one also, this religion of Islam, the Quran, is also on. So Ibrahim gave us the name. The name actually came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the first one who pronounced it was Ibrahim. And he gave us, as Muslims, he called us Muslims, because we accepted the Islam. And Islam is submission, to submit yourself willingly and sincerely and peacefully. That is Islam. And the one who does is a Muslim. Then that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he called me Muslim before, and after, and now, even the, with the message sent with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And why? وفي هذا ليكون الرسول شهيدا عليكم. In order for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be witness upon you, to be a witness that who is telling about you. So he is witness. And what about us? Allah is saying, وَتَكُونُ شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ. And you be witness upon other people. We are witness to among ourselves and also to the Christians. We know that they were called as Muslims before. It doesn't matter whether they changed it or not. And we know Judaism, they were Muslims. But if they changed it, that's another issue. And we are Muslims, and we change, it's upon us. It's after, it's only up to us if we change our name. So each one of those three Ibrahim religions, they keep splitting into pieces and groups and sections and more sectors, and each one taking a new name. And then that's why they left the name Muslim behind, or away behind. And we are on the way now. And that one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that all those prophets after Ibrahim, they were ruling people with Islam, and they were Muslims. And Allah is saying, يَحْكُمُ بِهَا النَّبِيُّونَ الَّذِينَ أَسْلَمُوا. And it is that religion which prophets who were accepted Islam and became Muslims, they used to rule with that religion. The rules and the regulations of this religion, which is Islam. And anyone who accepts it is Muslim. And then, and Prophet Ibrahim gave bequest. He told us this one, he told his children and grandchildren. And the prophets after him keep saying the same thing. Let us pick up an example. Prophet Yaqub, alayhi salam, when he was giving the last final word to his children, he said to them, ماذا تعبدون من بعدي? What will you, my boys, my girls, what will you worship? What will you worship, my children? He asked them, and they said to him, قالوا نعبد إلهك وإله آبائك إبراهيم وإسماعيل وإسحاق إلها واحدا ونحن لو مسلمون. We will worship your Lord, your Ilah, your Allah, and the Allah of your father, and your fathers, Abakum Ibrahim, we will worship the Allah, the Almighty of your father. And it's your Allah, and the Allah of your father, and the Allah of your grandfather, Ibrahim, and Ismail, and Ishaq. And who is Ilah Wahid, and who is only one Allah? وَنَحْنُ اللَّهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. And we submit ourselves to him, and that's why we are Muslims. So they took that covenant as Muslims. That's how they became Muslims, and they have been Muslims, and being Muslim has been continuous. Come to all the prophets were like that. Come to Jesus, that is Isa Masih alayhi salam. What did he say? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about that in the Quran frequently, saying, for example, وَإِذْ أُوحِيتُ إِلَى الْحَوَارِيِّينَ أَنْ آمِنُوا بِي وَرَبِّي وَبِرُسُلِي قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَاشْهَدْ بِأَنَّنَا مُسْلِمُونَ. Allah is telling us, he's saying, remember when I inspired the disciples of Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, and we inspired them to worship us as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to believe in anything but Allah and his messengers. And they said, قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ. Indeed, we believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَشْهَدْ بِأَنَّنَا مُسْلِمُونَ. Be witness that we are Muslimun. So the disciples of Prophet Jesus were Muslims. And anyone who follows Jesus exactly the way it is was a Muslim. And then it is all that continuously. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was also asked to say the same thing and to mention that all his activities are based on Islam, and because of that he is Muslim. And Allah says to him, قُلْ, say to them, إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And at the end, وَأَنَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. say to them that my prayer, my sacrifice, the sacrificial slaughtering for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my life and my death, all of them are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm not one of the mushrikeen. Say to them that, وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, and I'm the first of the Muslimin, of this, the last group of Muslims who are our Islam now. So Allah is telling to us, and tens of times in the Quran, that our name is only Muslim. Neither this sect, neither this sect, neither this madhab, not this madhab. It is unfortunate, brothers and sisters, that today some of us are calling themselves, we are from this group. And even they don't get the name, you take the name of a Muslim leader, a Muslim scholar, who was a great man. May Allah reward them. They did their best to contribute to Islam. And then you pick up their name, or you pick up the name of their tribe or their clans. So when I call myself like I'm Shafi'iya, Shafi'iya is the tribe of Prophet, the Shafi'is, the clan of Muhammad al-Idris, the founder of that, say, the scholar. It is his clan. Am I biologically that group? I'm not coming from, I'm not the descendants of that father. I'm not from that clan, biologically. But he was my teacher. I can say he's the one who taught us. That's good. May Allah reward him. It's all that. But you should not limit yourself to one group. You should be Muslim. Because that is the only thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to be. It is our identity. We cannot identify ourselves, and we cannot choose the pick the name we want. It is the name that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. And when he gave us, Allah said to us, as like we can see like the last word, the farewell statement, Allah is saying to us, قُلْ إِنَّ, Allah is saying to us, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Who is better than in speech? The one who said, the one who called Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then did good deeds, become richest person, and finally says, وَأَنَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, I am one of the Muslimin. I am a member of the Muslims. Never say I'm a member of group so and so, I'm sect that so and so. And by the way, the last verse of Allah, so that of the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, was that Allah is saying to us, Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-islam din. Today I have completed and perfected your religion, and I perfected the bounds of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you. وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا, and I am only pleased that you become Muslims and take the Islam. Islam is the religion that I am accepting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling to us that very clearly. And our name is Muslim. But then, if we divide among ourselves and go to groupism, then it's our problem. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned us from this very clearly, saying in the Quran, بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ وَكَانُوا شِيَعًا لَسْتَ مِنْهُمْ. Allah is saying to us, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ, indeed, those who فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ, those who divided their religion and took into groups, وَكَانُوا شِيَعًا, and became even Shia. Because Shia is like rebels. You went to rebel this group, you become a rebel on this way, and you become another rebel to this way. So those who became Shia and groups and so, less than them. You prophet, you are not from them. So they cannot claim you because they claimed something else. So the moment you claim something other than Islam, then you answer to yourself, are you Muslim or not? Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, I advise myself and to yourself that we stick to Islam and be Muslims, be proud of being Muslims, not to take a group or a small sect or a small cult and so. That is only wasting of time and it misleads us. Please make sure our name will be only Muslim and we stay on Islam, on following the commandments of Islam.